Critical cargo on the next space station resupply mission, NASA is at a virtual Earth and Space Science meeting, and a key piece of hardware installed on the Orion spacecraft. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. NASA partner SpaceX's 21st commercial resupply services mission to the International Space Station is using the company's upgraded Dragon spacecraft to deliver supplies and payloads, including the first commercially funded space station airlock and critical materials for the multitude of science and research investigations that will be conducted by the Expedition 64 and 65 crews. At this year's virtual meeting of the American Geophysical Union, NASA and researchers from around the world are presenting new findings on Earth and space science topics. These include news about the Solar Orbiter mission, findings about environmental trends due to the coronavirus pandemic, an update on Jupiter's cyclones, and more. The virtual meeting runs through December 17th. For more details, check out nasa.gov/AGU. The forward bay cover has been installed to the top of the Orion spacecraft for our Artemis I mission, the first uncrewed flight of the spacecraft around the moon and back. This critical piece of hardware will protect Orion's crew module as it travels back through Earth's atmosphere at speeds of more than 25,000 miles per hour. The cover will eventually be jettisoned to allow the three main parachutes to open and slow the capsule down enough for safe splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. Meanwhile, the Orion spacecraft structural test article is back at our Langley Research Center in preparation for another series of water impact tests scheduled for early next year. Data from these tests will be used for final computer modeling of the Orion capsule for Artemis II, the program's first mission with astronauts around the moon and back. Artemis II will also pave the way to land the first woman and next man on the moon by 2024 during Artemis III. Our Viper robot will be the first off-world rover to have its brains split in two, effectively using onboard flight software and software running from mission control on Earth to help it search for water ice on the surface of the moon. Teams at our Ames Research Center recently began putting the software through its paces using an engineering prototype of the rover. Viper is planned for delivery to the moon as early as December 2022 through our Commercial Lunar Payload Services Initiative. Thanks to the Chandra X-ray Center's data sonification project, you can now see and listen to images of some familiar cosmic objects. Data sonification takes information collected by telescopes and converts it into sounds, with the data in some cases being heard as various musical instruments and/or as sounds within different audio frequencies. Imagery data from NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory, Hubble Space Telescope, and Spitzer Space Telescope are featured. You can check it out at go.nasa.gov/cosmicsounds. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.